guys, we are back. It is week three. This is the last day before I take that back. Second last day before my first deload in this training cycle. I'm taking out speed work. I'm going to only repetition effort work, and I'm following Pudelpink's chart to do so. And this repetition effort work is to fix mainly my hip shift on squatting and my slight shifting and weaknesses or breakdowns during fatigue and deadlifting. Also, I have a rotation in my trunk to my right during bench press. So all of these repetition effort days are manipulated to make sure that I am not screwing that up. So interesting thing with squatting, you can see right there on the last two reps that was shifting to the right, and we've alleviated this. We figured it out. This was one of the last days that I figured out what was going wrong with it. So if you, in my brain, if I'm shifting to the right, that's telling me that something on the left side wasn't working properly. So I was trying to overcompensate, open up my left hip, wasn't working too well. What we ended up finding is I needed to actually open up my right hip more, turn that foot open, and actually needed to activate that glute more. It alleviated the problem instantly. Although I feel like I am favoring my right side, it evened me out, and it has been consistent ever since because I'm backlogging these videos. I know that it's working. Deadlifting, starting off percentage-wise, lighter. It feels good. I'm having zero grip issues. I'm really working on leveraging or making my spine long and extending my spine from a length standpoint, not a curvature standpoint. So Trevor Jaffe and Chris Bridgeford talk about this often. I want to make from my hips to my head like a very long tire iron. That's what I'm trying to do. I struggle with it the most on my first rep. All reps after that because of my eccentric is awesome. So you will see my head be the last thing to lift before I deadlift. That is because I am focusing on pulling on the bar to get the slack out, starting to do the splits to take more slack out, and then I am leveraging my head to elongate my spine to get me in the most advantageous position prior to spreading the floor or doing the splits to move the weight. And my upper back is super weak. So while working with Julia, snatch grip deadlifts destroyed me for literally 3 days after I did them. So I am now carrying those over into my programming. So for this entire block of eccentrics, I was doing snatch grip, rack pulls for sets of eight, I believe, this last 3 weeks, and it was very effective.